Hey guys, so today I'm gonna be looking at Dope Clicker. So Dope Clicker got updated, kind of like revamped basically, but the website has been changed. It looks a lot better and more industrial compared to the last one. So the pricing is still the same, relatively affordable at like 10 euros now. If you're like one of the people that's struggling to decide whether you should get a monthly or a lifetime, my suggestion would be not get the monthly at all if you're gonna buy it, because if at 5 euros you might as well get lifetime, right? You know, so if you really know and you're dead set on an auto clicker, then fine, get the lifetime. But if you're not set, that means you're probably hesitant because you need that extra advantage and you want to make sure of it, so you might as well get an internal ghost client like Vape, you know. So that's my take on it, but I don't think the monthly is worth it. If it was like 2.99 euros, then maybe, but I don't think at 4.99 it's really worth it for the monthly. So you might as well pay for the lifetime, because there's really no difference from these two. So yeah, and then there's also like a long presentation, a short presentation, which is kind of cool. I think this will be a short presentation, it's not really too long. But the menu has been changed and it clearly feels a lot more smoother. So there is a way that like developers kind of reduce the usage of clickers by lowering the seconds that the menu refreshes to make it look more pleasing to the eyes, which doesn't really matter, but to people that have decent computers, I guess it's a pretty good treat. But auto clickers right here, you have all your tooltips. The one that's mentioned in red is obviously the one aren't recommended for like good servers with good anti-cheats. And then right here you have like allow link shifting. So this is actually cool because you can get your pots. So you have jitter, which I don't really use, and I do like how like they have a button like this. That's kind of cool, I guess. I mean, it's nothing special really. And then blatant, maximize it and then turn it on. You have your keybind that you can bind to whatever you want. And then you have your slots. So let's say you only want like your sword slot, which is one, and you'll be fine. You would check this and you should be able to work just right, which is cool. And then you have click sounds. So these are just kind of recycled click sounds all over from 2017. So I'm not even that excited about it. I don't even use it. You got hide and self-destruct. And yeah, that's really much it. It's a pretty basic clicker. Now I do realize this is an issue. There's a little bit of input lag when I pull the slider on the R tab. Now this, I don't know if it's just me. Yeah, I can feel it very clearly. It's just the R slide. So maybe that's a little bug that I need to fix. And yeah, I hope you guys enjoy the video. It's just going to be gameplays that I got. And yeah, see you in the next video. Take care.
Just enough crushing, but I'm ready.